We sport walkers love our trails. And while most of the challenges we take on are predominantly trail-based, it's kind of pointless trying to pretend that roads and pavements don't exist. So, here are five ways you can embrace tarmac so that you can get more out of your sport walking on a day-to-day basis. The first thing you're likely to encounter when you step out of your home is tarmac, unless of course you're lucky enough to live in a remote croft in the Scottish Highlands. Roads, pavements, walking and cycleways are all around us, so why spend time driving or walking to get away from them? Learn to embrace them, especially for your day-to-day walks and training walks, and see them as a resource to be used. It's not about preferring them to trails, it's about seeing the positives, so you can save time or get your training done with less fuss. Tarmac is largely a clean and clear surface to walk on, so instead of constantly having to clean up your gear of mud, dust or other debris after you come back from the trails, walking for your day-to-day training on roads or pavements means you'll be saving yourself all that prep and clean-up time, especially if you're on a tight schedule. It also means you can use any training or running shoes, so if you've only got one pair of trail shoes for your challenges, you're not wearing them out during day-to-day walking. You can save them for the weekend when you naturally want to be more adventurous and go out on the trails. If you're walking on roads for your everyday training, when the weekend comes and you hit the trails, you'll enjoy them so much more. That's not to say that trail walking during the week means you'll lose appreciation for them, it's just that if you can do at least some of your weekday sessions on roads, it creates difference in your routine which will help you keep things fresh, and you'll have extra enthusiasm at the weekend when you hit the trails for your long training walks. Tarmac is on the whole smooth and regular, potholes aside. This means that it's great for working on your walking form and style and for perfecting and embedding those technique adaptations that will help you walk faster for longer. It's much easier to repeat technique adaptations on tarmac because of the regular surface. If you're trying to master leg drive on trails, you'll be continually facing disruptive elements such as mud, tree roots, rocks, and undulations. These don't stop you working on your technique, but they make it harder to bed in that muscle memory so you move instinctively. Do this work on tarmac and you'll make faster progress. Last but not least, there's a far bigger road network than there is a footpath network. And of course, all roads are mapped on widely available mapping software like Google Maps. So not only would you have greater scope to create a wider variety of routes, you'll never have to worry about getting lost or navigating back home if you come over all Bear Grylls and go, "Ooh, I wonder what's down that lane." There are, of course, some downsides to tarmac, most notably the fact that it's a hard, unforgiving surface, and also that you're more likely to encounter air pollution. Pollution is a harder thing to avoid, but if you limit your tarmac sessions to around 10 kilometers or 6 miles, you won't have to worry about the impact walking on roads has on your body. Just think of roads as being a resource, and use them to your benefit.